The onus was on India to create a conducive environment for meaningful and result-oriented engagement with Pakistan. I think also from the perspective of Jammu and Kashmir, most significant was the ministerial meeting of the OIC contact group, which unanimously adopted a strong communique that intralia reaffirmed OIC's solidarity and support for the legitimate struggle of Kashmiri people for realization of their inalienable right to self-determination and freedom from Indian occupation. It also demanded that India reverse all illegal and unilateral measures taken on or after 5th August 2019, immediately stop human rights violations, and halt and reverse the illegal demographic changes in the occupied territory. Let me also state that in the foreign minister's various interactions in New York, key messaging was on Jammu and Kashmir, Afghanistan, the importance of multilateralism to address the global challenges, and Pakistan's policy shift to geoeconomics based on peace, partnerships, and connectivity. You have also followed the foreign minister's engagement in the United Kingdom. And then we had the Danish foreign minister who was in Islamabad last week and Iran's deputy foreign minister for political affairs earlier this week. All of this reflective of our continuing engagement with the international community. The U.S. Deputy Secretary of State, Wendy Sherman, is visiting Pakistan from today and tomorrow. Her visit follows the recent meeting between the two foreign ministers in New York. During the visit, views will be exchanged on all issues of mutual interest, including the bilateral relationship, as well as the regional situation. Close and regular engagement between Pakistan and the United States has always been mutually beneficial and a factor for stability in South Asia. We look forward to reinforcing a balanced Pak-US relationship that is anchored in mutually beneficial cooperation in all areas, including security, trade, investment, energy, and regional connectivity. We remain deeply concerned on the grave situation in the Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir, where the brutality, state terrorism, war crimes, and systematic violations of human rights continue unabated by the Indian occupation forces. A young Kashmiri, Mujib Lone, was martyred during cordon and search operation in Shopian district recently. 14 innocent Kashmiris were martyred by Indian occupation forces in the month of September alone, while over 440 Kashmiris have been martyred by Indian troops since 5th August 2019. The extrajudicial killings of innocent Kashmiris and the blatant attempts to turn Muslims into a minority in the Indian illegally occupied Jammu and Kashmir through distribution of fake domicile certificates is another testimony of India's rapid descent into fascism. Indian illegal actions in IIOJK and the unresolved Jammu and Kashmir dispute has serious consequences in terms of threat to international peace and security and the human rights violations. We continue to sensitize the international community in this regard, utilizing all occasions, bilateral meetings and others, including the ongoing debates in the UNGA in New York and the Human Rights Council in Geneva.
Islamabad mein tarjuman daftar-e-Khwaja.